We want to compute the mean, variance, and standard deviation of this discrete probability distribution. We have all the values of the random variable x here, and the associated probabilities p here. The sum of the probabilities must be 1, so I can use the shortcut alt equals to sum the probabilities and ensure they add up to 1. Next, I'll create a bottom border to separate the sums of these columns. Let's call them totals. Next, I'm going to name these columns by selecting them, clicking on the Formulas tab, and clicking Create from Selection. Leave the top row checked since the names are in the top row, and click OK. First, let's compute the mean or expected value. Since the cells are already named, I'll simply type equals x times p. Enter. And the computation is done for the entire column. To calculate the expected value, I can use sum xp or simply drag the sum formula to the xp column. We could also use equals sum product x, p to directly obtain the mean or expected value. So for the mean, we have 6.75. To compute the variance, we can use any of these two formulas. Let's start with the computational formula. To obtain x squared times p of x equals x squared times p. Enter. I'll drag the sum formula to the right to obtain the total. The variance is thus equals sum of x squared p minus mean squared. I'm going to select these names and values under formulas. Create from selection. Ensure the left column is selected and click OK. We can now obtain the standard deviation as the square root of the variance. Now, using the definition of formula, equals x minus mean squared times p. Enter. On summing that column, we see that it confirms that the value of the variance we had before was correct. Now, using this as a template, this distribution has 5 x values or rows. Suppose I want to use it for a distribution with 6 x values. I can right-click on this row 5 and insert. Suppose I have an x value of 7 here with a probability of, say, 0.2. This is no longer a probability distribution since the total probability is no longer 1. Let's change this 0.3 to 0.1 so the total is 1 again. Finally, if I have only 4 x values, I can click on row 5, drag down to 6, right-click, and delete. To make the probability sum to 1, let's change this 0.1 to 0.4. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.